For Crystal Prince, saving her children's cord blood was an easy decision. Getting her hands on it for a sick daughter has proven more difficult. But Prince is not alone. She's just one of dozens of parents dealing with BIOBANC. Brian Lynch is flat out mad.
My worry would be that, God forbid, you need it. You need to get a hold of it. I don't feel that I can get a hold of these people to get the sample out or that they would do it properly.
Hundreds of parents put their faith and money into BIOBANC, but within 5 years, the company was bankrupt, unlicensed, under investigation, and on the verge of collapse.
At this point, like, I wouldn't be surprised. So if they were to say that, you know, it would be upsetting, but I wouldn't be shocked, because we've tried to get a hold of them, and we've, you know, for months, and we've driven over there, and so we've seen, you know, the operation basically is abandoned.
With children born premature and a family history of cancer, the Lynches banked cord blood with BIOBANC. But in the past year, they grew doubtful of the safety of their son's sample. The company stopped answering phone calls and emails. The Ryan Ranch offices were cleared out with no sign of the cryogenic blood storage tank.
For all I know, it's in an unplugged refrigerator in the basement of some building, you know, just defrosting. I have no idea.
We found the tank and the company's owners in a small corner office, a far cry from the state-of-the-art facility that impressed the original clients, like County Supervisor Dave Potter and former partner Dr. Robert Keller.
Great idea, a little before its time.
Keller bailed when the company moved to storing cord blood. BIOBANC lost money, lost key employees, and in 2010 lost its license. But we found them still doing business online. They also told us they took in cord blood samples as recently as July in violation of the law. They continue to bank the samples they have, even though they aren't licensed to do that either. Current owner Bo Hainer declined to speak on camera, but he did invite us into the lab to see the tank for ourselves. Off camera, Bo Hainer told us he's making every effort to get licensed and to protect the tank, but even he realizes that time is running out. Enter federal and state investigators. Ken August with the State Health Department confirms BIOBANC is under investigation by the state and the Food and Drug Administration to determine if the samples are being handled appropriately and that they are viable and protected. Tests are underway to determine if the samples are even usable anymore.
I'd like a piece of paper saying that the sample's there, it's fine, it's been maintained properly.
Hainer is not ready to quit, but investigators could make the decision for him come August and issue a cease and desist. Between now and then, everyone is waiting for test results on the viability of the blood.
That's even more of a sinking, terrible feeling, knowing that we've trusted in them.
Well, Dan, the testing could take a few weeks, but that, you know, obviously feels forever to parents like the Lynches and Crystal Prince. Crystal needs the blood, but she doesn't even know if this blood can even help her sick daughter, but it is a chance. Now, if the blood is in good condition, the next big hurdle is what happens to it. What happens to the tank? What happens to the samples? Who takes over this tank? None of that has been worked out yet. Dan.
All right. Very many questions. Thanks very much. Appreciate it, May. It should also be pointed out that there are very few medical guarantees that come with cord blood. But if you want to privately bank cord blood, it can be very expensive. There are public cord blood banks that are free. Duke University Medical Center offers a kit for expectant parents. Unlike private banks like BIOBANC, public cord blood donations are not held for the donor's family, but are used for any patient found to be a match. Parents interested in donating their baby's cord blood to the program can get more information at the website on your screen there, cancer.duke.edu/ccbb.